The world has always appreciated India for its traditions and rituals. A lot of daily habits of Indians make us different from others and make us proud Hindustanis. As you travel from one state to another, you will notice different customs, traditions and rituals. All these traditions are of great value in Indian culture, and these customs and traditions together make India a secular state within. We follow these traditions so casually in our life that we never notice them performing. For example, whenever any elderly passes by, we fold our hands and say Namaste in order to show respect. Have ever wondered that there could be a scientific reason to it? We too found out a few interesting facts about these traditions and thought to share with our viewers. After watching this video, you will come to know how our inherited traditions possess great scientific values. 10 Amazing Scientific Reasons Behind Hindu Traditions. Piercing the ears has a great importance in Indian ethos. Indian physicians and philosophers believe that piercing the ears helps in the development of intellect, power of thinking and decision-making faculties. Talkativeness fritters away life energy. Ear piercing helps in speech restraint. It helps to reduce impertinent behavior, and the ear canals become free from disorders. This idea appeals to the Western world as well, and so they are getting their ears pierced to wear fancy earrings as a mark of fashion. Myth is that it invites ghost or death, but science says that it is because human body has its own magnetic field, also known as heart's magnetic field, because the flow of blood and earth is a giant magnet. When we sleep with head towards north, our body magnetic field become completely asymmetrical to the earth magnetic field. That cause problems related to blood pressure, and our heart needs to work harder in order to overcome this asymmetry of magnetic fields. Apart from this, another reason is that our body have significant amount of iron in our blood. When we sleep in this position, iron from the whole body starts to congregate in brain. This can cause headache, Alzheimer's disease, cognitive decline, Parkinson's disease and brain degeneration. This tradition is not just about sitting on floor and eating, it is regarding sitting in the Uttanasana position and then eating. Uttanasana is the position we normally use for yoga asanas. When you sit on the floor, you usually sit cross-legged in Uttanasana, which are poses that instantly bring a sense of calm and help in digestion. It is believed to automatically trigger the signals to your brain to prepare the stomach for digestion. Besides lending color to the hands, mani is a very powerful medicinal herb. Weddings are stressful, and often the stress causes headaches and fevers. As the wedding day approaches, the excitement mixed with nervous anticipation can take its toll on the bride and groom. Application of mani can prevent too much stress because it cools the body and keeps the nerves from becoming tense. This is the reason why mani is applied on the hands and feet, which house nerve endings in the body. Our ancestors have stressed on the fact that our meals should be started off with something spicy, and sweet dishes should be taken towards the end. The significance of this eating practice is that while spicy things activate the digestive juices and acids and ensure that the digestion process goes on smoothly and efficiently, sweets or carbohydrates pulls down the digestive process. Hence, sweets were always recommended to be taken as a last item. People who are visiting the temple should and will ring the bell before entering the inner sanctum, also called as Garbhagudi or Garbhagriha or womb chamber, where the main idol is placed. According to Agama Sastra, the bell is used to give sound for keeping evil forces away, and the ring of the bell is pleasant to God. However, the scientific reason behind bells is that their ring clears our mind and helps us stay sharp and keep our full concentration on devotional purpose. These bells are made in such a way that when they produce a sound, it creates a unity in the left and right parts of our brains. The moment we ring the bell, it produces a sharp and enduring sound, which lasts for a minimum of 7 seconds in echo mode. The duration of echo is good enough to activate all the seven healing centers in our body. This results in emptying our brain from all negative thoughts. On the forehead, between the two eyebrows, is a spot that is considered as a major nerve point in human body since ancient times. The Tialik is believed to prevent the loss of energy. The red umbilicus between the eyebrows is said to retain energy in the human body and control the various levels of concentration. While applying kumkum, the points on the midbrow region and Ajna chakra are automatically pressed. This also facilitates the blood supply to the face muscles. The general reasoning given for this act is that it brings good luck. However, scientifically speaking, in the ancient times, most of the currency used was made of copper, unlike the stainless steel coins of today. Copper is a vital metal very useful to the human body. Throwing coins in the river was one way our forefathers ensured we intake sufficient copper as part of the water, as rivers were the only source of drinking water. Making it a custom ensured that all of us follow the practice. Wearing toe rings is not just the significance of married women, but there is science behind it. Normally, toe rings are worn on the second toe. A particular nerve from the second toe connects the uterus and passes to heart. Wearing toe ring on this finger strengthens the uterus. It will keep it healthy by regulating the blood flow to it, and menstrual cycle will be regularized. As silver is a good conductor, it also absorbs polar energies from the earth and passes it to the body. In Hindu culture, people greet each other by joining their palms, termed as a maskar. The general reason behind this tradition is that greeting by joining both the palms means respect. However, scientifically speaking, joining both hands ensures joining the tips of all the fingers together, which are denoted to the pressure points of eyes, ears, and mind. Pressing them together is said to activate the pressure points, which helps us remember that person for a long time. And, no germs, since we don't make any physical contact